I should be clear at the start, this is not a review. This is kind of a video you should treat as being an extremely biased video. Let me explain. From time to time, I get to work with a bunch of different companies, and sometimes when I think it's interesting, I take you along for the ride. In the past, I made a video about my visit to Bellwether, a company making really interesting smart roasters for cafes over in Berkeley in California. This is another company from that part of the world that I got to do some work with. They just launched, which is why I can finally talk about this now, and I think it's an interesting little story. Now, the main reason you should treat this video as being deeply, deeply biased is that I am involved with Taika as an advisor and also a little bit, I suppose, as an investor. So I have a vested interest here. This will explain why I do not do reviews of specialty coffee in cans or bottles or anything in the ready-to-drink market because I have a massive bias there. If they want to put cranberry, lemonade, and cold brew in something, that's just not a specialty product, and I think that's fair game for discussing. But if someone's doing really good coffee in cans or bottles, I just don't want to talk about it because I have a conflict of interest. So the reason for today's video is not to talk about me having a conflict of interest, though I think it's very important that people who have platforms do that, so that's done. And the goal is not just to tell you to buy this. Yes, I think it tastes good, but of course I think it tastes good. I'm kind of involved in it. I got a little bit of a say into some aspects of it. That's not the point. What I do think is interesting to talk about is a kind of little piece of philosophy that's the kind of why about why I work with this company. Now, I've known Cal, one of the co-founders, for a long time. We messed around making Instant together before he went and started Sudden. And I had coffee with him not too long ago, and we were talking about this and what he wanted to do. And he made what I thought was a very good point. He pointed out that specialty coffee is very focused on the journey, on how the coffee got to you. That's the provenance, the traceability, the who, the why, the where, the what of that particular coffee. That's very important. That's kind of key to specialty coffee. What he felt was missing was a focus on the destination. How does that cup of coffee make you feel? Which I think is a really interesting thing. I hadn't really thought about it in those terms quite as neatly before. And I think there's something really important in there. We're really reluctant to talk about anything but the journey, and I don't think you have to abandon talking about the journey to talk about the destination. Specialty coffee is delicious and it's interesting, but we rarely, if ever, talk about how it makes you feel. How does it make me feel? What do I want it to make me feel? Now, there are lots of destinations. There's lots of reasons we drink cups of coffee. The reason you might drink a cup of coffee at 5 in the morning is different from the reason you would drink a cup of coffee at 3 in the afternoon. And we don't really talk about that. The goal with Taika is that they wanted to focus on the time that you drink coffee to feel alert and focused. And they tried to make that better. And so the goal here was put a fixed and known amount of caffeine in each can, which is kind of interesting, but not for now. And then a few other adaptogens to sort of increase your alertness, like l-theanine and that kind of a thing, but also not make you feel jittery and weird. That's the goal here. That's what they're trying to do. And I'm not going to go too deep on this because if you're interested, there's a link in the description. Go and read about it. But for the rest of us, I think having a bit more of a focus about how coffee makes us feel, about the why when we drink coffee, might be really interesting. I don't think you have to compromise the journey stuff. I don't think you have to compromise any aspect of its quality. A lot of this ties in with a bunch of work that the SCA did, where they tried to understand better the relationship that a lot of consumers have with specialty coffee, and they found it to be a long way away from the relationship that we inside the industry have with it. It was a much more emotional relationship. It was much more about how it made them feel than it was about the minutiae, about the detail that drives, you know, people like me and others to get very excited about specific coffees. I took a bunch away from my work here, and I kind of want to ask the question to you. What do you want coffee to make you feel? Is it alert? Is it entertained? Is it informed? Is it a very intellectual experience? Do you just want comfort? Do you want a bunch of different things throughout the day too? The favorite cups of coffee that you've had, how do they make you feel? We don't talk about this stuff very much, and I think it's really important and it's really interesting. And leave me a comment down below if you've tried these. I did not think I was a macadamia nut latte guy, but I am. I really am. It's delicious. But for now, I'll say thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a great day.